Hello once again, everyone, from ringside. Mike Tenay, joined by Don West. And Don, if you remember back, the challenge was initially rejected by Sabu, but the repeated mind games, the physical brutality towards Sabu's partner Sanjay Dutt, and the lack of respect shown by Raven towards the memory of the Sheik leads us to this point, and finally the match is underway.
Well, you know what, Mike? He took all that he could take, and you see right here, as he comes flying over the top rope to Sabu, is ready. He also has Raven painted on his chest, as Raven has Sabu on his. Lest they forget about this feud that has been going on. Sabu couldn't take it anymore. He said one night only, and when the 1-2-3 was over, that this feud would be over.
That's really the key, this rivalry, this matchup that has finally come to a head. Sabu has sent word that after this matchup tonight, after he gets the 1-2-3, after he defeats Raven, it is done. It's history.
Well, you see him right here setting up Raven. He came right up like a house of fire, setting him up, but now going for his signature chair. And you see Rob on top of the table, takes the ball, but then wisely gets off.
We understand that TNA officials have instructed referee Andrew Thomas that the only thing that matters in this match is the pinfall. Look at Sabu 5.
Well, there's no way you're going to control these two, because this isn't about the rules with these two. This is about the rivalry. This is about the anger that they take care for each other. There's no way Andrew Thomas can sit here and try to keep order, because these guys wouldn't stop.
I think it's really a great move, a preemptive move by TNA management, TNA officials, and in essence, that allows Andrew Thomas the leeway to let us all get a winner in this one-on-one match. Sabu positioning the chair, going to spring off the chair and catch Raven in the corner with the leg.
It's been all Sabu from the beginning, as he has been focused, obviously, this week totally on Raven. And Raven's been spending so much time playing the mind game, I wonder if he's going to be prepared, because Sabu obviously is.
And now,
look at this!
Sabu, he's got what appears to be, I guess, a screwdriver, is it?
Oh, it looks like something like that with a sharp point, and man, he's going right at Raven with it.
Some type of a weapon as he just drives it right into the head of Raven. Measuring him again, going to charge at him, but Raven's ready to...
What a counter as he sends Sabu right there over the ropes onto the table.
And look at Raven's head, obviously a victim of that attack by Sabu and the weapon that he used. But then Raven with the instincts, can we take another look?
That's exactly right, Mike. Total instinct right here. Look at that. Raven, Sabu going for to end it right there and now.
And you see that Sabu is not only crashed through the table, but also crashed into the steel guardrail, the steel safety rail, certainly favoring his leg and his ankle as well.
Raven, though, cut wide open with the stake that Sabu brought in. It's the same stick that you saw Raven have in his hand a few weeks back.
Yeah, that he chased me out of the ring.
That's
with,
right,
of all things.
Oh, look at this. Setting him up on the chair, catching him underneath the chin. Oh, that's wicked. You're lucky sometimes you'll bite your tongue off.
And Raven has totally turned this matchup around. You're right, almost from the start. Sabu on the attack, but look at what Raven is doing. He's pulling out all the stops.
You see Sabu still holding his left knee when Raven sent him over the ropes on the table. Oh, as Raven just slams the chair right into the forehead of Sabu.
What an offense by Raven here, using the steel chair, those repeated shots to the throat, to the windpipe of Sabu, then dropping the leg using the chair, and now wedging the steel chair between the top and middle rope.
It's almost like the spike was some sort of a wake-up call to Raven, because ever since he got Sabu over the ropes into the chair, he has taken the offensive and been in control. Now he throws Sabu right into the chair with his prop deck between the ropes.
Follow cover. Referee Thomas puts in the count, but no, just a 2 count for Raven on Sabu. And almost, if you think about it, timing-wise, once Raven felt that blood flowing down his head, down into his face and into his eyes, we've seen a totally different Raven, who is so destructive, so physically brutal. Steel chair shot to the head.
I'll tell you what, is again, every time, watch how Sabu grabs that left leg. He's in pain, and he's having to hold his head with one hand, the leg with the other. Raven right now is really damaging Sabu, and again, another shot into the chair.
Face first into the steel. Pin attempt and another near fall for Raven, another 2 count.
Well, Raven's goaded Sabu for so long. What's been 2-3 months this thing's been going on? He's got his wrist right here, and he's taking advantage of it.
You want to
give up? The smile, the eerie, smile
trying to... Oh my God. Trying to imagine there that Raven was using that move, a camel clutch type move that Sabu's uncle, the Sheik, made so famous. I'm sure trying to send a message and play even another level of mind games with Sabu.
Oh, Sabu right there with the chair. He used it so well, being used against him time and time again. Raven Dawkins, he did a lot of homework, and there's a ball right into the chair.
Another one of Raven's patented moves. Face first goes Sabu right into the steel. And you notice Raven's not even going for a cover here. He's got something else up his sleeve, and obviously now positioning the steel chair in place. Going to use that as a weapon again.
Oh, he knows he's got Sabu dizzy. He knows he's got Sabu reeling. Again, he does it again, man!
Second time, Raven goes to the well. Drop pole hold, and a second time, Sabu goes face and head first right into the chair. Let's take another look. This is the first one. Oh,
watch out. Head caught right on the edge of the chair. Crowd yelling for Sabu, trying to get him picked up here, but Sabu. Oh, good move there. The
Sabu able to spring off the top, make contact with the kick, but again you see him favoring the ankle that he crashed into the safety rail with earlier.
I'll tell you what though, on instinct alone, he was able to climb up that chair on the ropes and do the backflip back because he did pain right there, but you just gotta put it out of your mind, Mike.
Almost as if we saw Sabu come to the ring with the months of pent-up frustration and the offensive assault. It was answered by Raven, but now Sabu turned it around again, and the steel chair goes right into the face of Raven.
Well, these guys are going through such a range of emotion right there, and Sabu just needed a little bit of an edge, and he got it when Raven went for the third drop toe. He was able to counter, and now he's got control, and he hits him with the chair for the third time.
It really has been a roller coaster ride of emotions between these two, as now Sabu, obviously here in tribute to his late uncle, the Sheik, goes to the Sheik's finishing move, the camel clutch.
Oh, you can see right there the blood pouring down from Raven. Eventually here, that might become a big factor because he's going to lose strength if the more blood he loses. Great move there by Sabu, kind of returning the favor. Good move again, didn't even give Raven time to think.
Repeated leg drops using the steel chair again as a weapon. We go a third time and drops down, crashes down onto Raven.
Could this be the 1-2-3?
Reach the arm, gets two. Nope, Raven still has the strength to use his leg power to kick out at two.
I'll tell you what, it's amazing these guys got anything left in the tank because, you know, I talked about it, they're emotionally spent right now. Not to mention physically, but... Oh, look at this. Sabu going up again. Catches Raven with his knees. But again, he goes to grab that left leg.
Springs off the chair, then off the top rope. Version of the moonsault, right crashing down onto Raven, but I'm not sure how wise it was to use that move after he injured the knees earlier. Pin attempt, no. Another two count.
It looks like he just didn't quite have enough right there as he went for the pin, but Raven able to push him over the top, and I think that Sabu is really concerned now with that left leg.
Sabu
limping noticeably.
Headed towards the corner, up to the middle rope. Now going to go to the top.
Oh, man, here he goes. Here it is.
Opportunity now for Raven to take control. Breaks the arm. And...
Oh, Sabu right there almost caught off guard. Obviously, it took a lot out of him when he missed. I think he felt that kind of hit his head right there. Raven saw the opportunity and went for the quick pin.
Advantage has certainly swung back and forth between these competitors. Right now, Raven feels like he can go underneath the ring. He has the time to take out a table.
Oh, he's setting up another one as the first one's been demolished. Raven going to throw it into the ring, Mike.
And circling around the ring.
Sabu's
doing
trying
here.
To see what Raven's doing to Sabu in the ring. He's getting the chair up.
Raven looking for something else under the ring, but obviously giving up on that photo.
Sabu, wise move right there. While Raven was focused on something, Sabu able to get the table set up and take advantage of throwing hit Raven with the chair.
A couple of shots with the steel chair. Now Sabu looking for a weapon. He's got another chair underneath the ring. Going to come back in, going to position that chair in place.
Oh, look at him slamming the bloody head of Raven right into the chair, Mike.
Oh, no. Up from the middle rope. Oh! He just sandwiched him that time with the leg drop.
What you call a metal sandwich right there. And I mean, Raven's ears have got to be ringing. This is the advantage that Sabu needs. He's going to use it to get Raven on the table and save him.
Think about how that kind of impact can not only jar your head, but jar your neck as well. And now Sabu's going to spring. First off the chair.
beautiful! The ropes into the table! Wow! But it took a lot out of him, Mike. Look at that!
Sabu able to connect with the leg drop. Crowd at the TNA Asylum trying to cheer him on. Can he go for the pin? Here's the cover. Leg drop.
He no, got it! No, no Raven just him enough! Wait a minute. What in the world? Who's that?
What's that? Who's that?
Oh, my God. Completely cloaked.
A wounded figure. Where was that? Where was that shot?
I'm trying to find it. Well, we don't want to miss the action, but that was weird.
I guess up in the upper level, I'm getting word now from the truck as we see Sabu.
Oh, look at Raven fighting back, Mike. It's going on adrenaline, trying to somehow stop the force of Sabu. Oh, Raven was able to counter by holding onto the ropes, and Sabu lost the advantage.
Very smart move. Into the DDT. Using the rope.
Oh, wait a minute. Andrew Thomas wisely saw that the feet were on the ropes, even though he already went for the three count. They had to stop it. That was a great move on Andrew Thomas.
Series of reversals. Oh, Raven effect. DDT surprised me. I'm sure it shocked Sabu. Caught him out of nowhere.
He got it.
No!
Sabu kicked out of something that nobody
kicked
out of.
How many times have you seen that happen?
Oh, you got that right.
The look on the face of Raven tells the entire story. He hit his patented Raven effect DDT. Miraculously, Sabu able to kick out at two.
Both these guys are doing this. I mean, like I said, it's just sheer willpower. As Sabu drilled Raven through the table earlier, then Raven hit him with his patented even flow DDT. Sabu kicked out. And here comes another table.
Raven goes underneath the six-sided ring. That's the opportunity for Sabu to come back. Catches him with the chair, and now Sabu's going to put the table in position.
I mean, both these guys, their minds have just got to be reeling right now. Both of them thinking, what do I got to do to beat the other one? Sabu setting Raven up again on the table that Raven brought in. And here goes Sabu to the top. Look at that, though. Raven sliding down the table and kicking Sabu in the crotch to get the advantage.
Another perfect counter by Raven. Is he going to go? Table crashing down. You talk about improvising. Raven effect DDT. Spiked him head first into the table.
Just think about the force it would have had. Is it going to be enough? One, two, it's done.
The winner of the match, Raven.
Doesn't even have the strength to celebrate, Mike.
What a battle between these two. What a way to start off the night of revenge. The matchup decades